Good evening. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Welcome to Mass. This evening, a wild night, so not surprising we are fewer in number than normal, and forecast this to get worse before it gets better. So I think we'll keep moving tonight, get you home nice and sharp. The second Sunday of the year, this may come as news to you, you may know it already. The Gospel, no matter which Gospel we're going to read, and this year we're going to read Matthew, is always from John's Gospel. Why? Because in Matthew, Mark and Luke, everybody's on a voyage of discovery as to discovering who Jesus is, whereas John's Gospel, directly from the very beginning, explains something about the nature of the Lord Jesus. And today is a good example of it. John the Baptist does the job for us. So for an openness to what we are prompted to understand, and for a desire to live as we are called to, we pray, and that we may do so worthily, we call to mind our sins, and we ask God's pardon. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the prayers of your people. Bestow your peace on our times. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Lord said to me, "You are my servant Israel, in whom I shall be glorified. I was honored in the eyes of the Lord. My God was my strength. And now the Lord has spoken. He who formed me in the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, to gather Israel to him. It is not enough for you to be my servant, to restore the tribes of Jacob and bring back the survivors of Israel. I will make you the light of the nations, so that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm, "Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will."
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
I waited for the Lord, and he stooped down to me. He heard my cry. He put a new song into my mouth, praise of our God.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
You do not ask for sacrifice and offerings, but an open ear. You do not ask for holocaust and victim. Instead, here am I.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
In the scroll of the book it stands written that I should do your will. My God, I delight in your law in the depth of my heart.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Your justice I have proclaimed in the great assembly. My lips I have not sealed. You know it, O Lord.
Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I, Paul, appointed by God to be an apostle, together with Brother Sosthenes, send greetings to the Church of God in Corinth, to the holy people of Jesus Christ, who are called to take their place among all the saints everywhere, who pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, for he is their Lord no less than ours. May God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ send your grace and peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The word was made flesh and lived among us. To all who did accept him, he gave power to become children to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Seeing Jesus coming towards him, John said, "Look, there is the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. This is the one I spoke of when I said, 'A man is coming after me who ranks before me, because he existed before me.' I did not know him myself, and yet it was to reveal him to Israel that I came, baptizing with water." And John also declared, "I saw the Spirit coming down on him from heaven like a dove, resting on him. I did not know him myself, but he who sent me to baptize with water had said to me, 'The one on whom you see the Spirit come down and rest is the one who is going to baptize with the Holy Spirit.' Yes, I have seen, and I am the witness that he is the chosen one of God." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The very famous English author, the man of letters, G.K. Chesterton, is credited with saying, "When people stop believing in God, it's not that they'll believe nothing, it's that they'll believe anything." And I think in the modern world, with a variety of cults and practices, we see there's truth in that. Since the trains were on strike this week, I went to Glasgow on the bus, and it's always an education, apart from having to visit Braehead. There's a guy talking to his pal in the road behind me, and he was talking about his, he called it a belief system, his philosophy of life, and it was an education. I'm glad I was sitting in front of him because he couldn't see my eyebrows waggling up and down, because he was picking three things from Catholicism, four things from Presbyterianism, some Episcopalian beliefs, and a sprinkling of Buddhism, and he kind of made this recipe for life. It was entertaining, but not, I wouldn't have thought, a particularly valid alternative to the faith that we share, to a greater or lesser extent, stronger at some times in our lives and weaker at others. But nonetheless, we know that we're nourished by the gospel above all, by our prayer together, by our communion of life, and by our desire to recognise the presence of the Lord in the sacraments. And I suppose if I had 5 minutes between here and Braehead to tell somebody about that, that's the kind of approach I would take. This is not new, that there should be, alongside mainstream religion, other beliefs or other significant figures that influence. And one of them, and we don't always maybe give significance to it because we move on quickly from John the Baptist to Jesus, was there was a very strong cult around the Mediterranean basin of followers of John the Baptist. He, in his own right, had a great number of followers. As we know, some of them became followers of Jesus, as the Gospel tells us. Others remained in that Baptist sect, if you like, or the Baptist cult, And you may not remember this, but in Acts of the Apostles, when Paul visits Ephesus, and this will be about the year 55 AD, he discovers people, and he says, they seem to be believers, and he said, who laid hands on you to receive the Holy Spirit? Because, of course, that was the job of the apostles and those whom they appointed to found early Christian communities in different cities around the Mediterranean. And they said, we've never even heard that there's such a thing as a Holy Spirit. We only received the baptism of John. And Paul's reaction is very interesting. He says, John's baptism was a baptism of repentance, but the baptism that you receive when you become a follower of the Lord Jesus is a baptism with the Holy Spirit, a baptism of power, of love, and of self-control, he says. And it's a very intriguing way of putting it. Not just a baptism of repentance, but a baptism that gives the Holy Spirit and gives us power and love and self-control. And there's one really significant flick of that which I find really valuable. Repentance is what we do for our failure. John the Baptist points to Jesus and he says, here is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. The gift of forgiveness that the Lord Jesus brings is not dependent on our repentance the way the baptism of John was a baptism of repentance, but rather it's about a gift, and we don't need to do anything to possess it other than embrace it. We don't have to deserve it. We just have to embrace it as a gift of God. And it's a forgiveness that gives us the gift of the Holy Spirit, the gift of power, of love, and of self-control. And I think if we can recognize that that's what the Holy Spirit gives us, power and love and self-control, because think what two would be like without the third, or one would be like without the other two. Power could be fine, but if it's not exercised with love and with self-control, then it becomes a power that is not contained, not useful, and not directed. So to recognize that we are gifted in that way, and that we are called, as we heard tonight, to be the witnesses to the Lord Jesus so that his salvation reaches the ends of the earth, for that strength, that courage, for that power, that love, that self-control the Holy Spirit gives us by virtue of the baptism that we have received, not dependent on our repentance, but rather on the forgiveness of the Lord for each other and ourselves, we pray this evening. To pray for our needs, we stand.
As you have called your chosen ones to be your witnesses, give power to the church to witness faithfully. Since by grace we have known the true Messiah, may we make him known to others. As the first disciples followed Christ to his dwelling, so may his servants at this time come to him and rest with him. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Bless the people of this world with wisdom to know the Lord and the will to follow him. Holy Spirit, descending on him and abiding in him, enter into the dark places of the world to banish ignorance and reveal the Saviour who has come. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
As Andrew brought his brother to Christ, so may we bring to him those who are close to us, but do not yet know the fullness of his love. May he come into our homes and make them his own. May he, the great teacher, give light to all who teach and all who learn in this community. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Have mercy on those who seek rest and cannot find it. Give them hope in Christ, who calls the seekers to find their peace in him. Come to the lonely ones who have no one to walk with them and show them the way. May they find human friendship and divine love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Grant eternal rest to those who have come at last to where Christ dwells in glory. As they have sought him and tried to serve him in this world, may they see him with full vision and abide in him forever. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. To these our general intercessions, we add prayer for our own particular and local needs, remembering those who have asked us to pray for them, especially those whom we know to be in particular need at this time. Pray for those who join us on the live stream, particularly if they are unwell or caring for others, either within the context of family or as their vocation in life. Lord, will be with them, give them strength, courage, and bless them for their generosity. Pray for ourselves, that we may recognize that our lives in Christ are not all about repentance, but rather about receiving the gift of the Holy Spirit through our baptism and exercising our witness with power and with love and with self-control. And finally, we pray for our dead. We remember those who have died recently, especially David McGivern, and those whose anniversaries occur about now, especially those who have been asked to remember in prayer. That they may all know the presence of God. Lord, hear us. God, our Father, you call us to be your people, to embrace our gift of salvation and your gifts of forgiveness, of power, of love, and of self-control. Help us to be effective as your witnesses. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we've received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we've received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Let's pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our salvation is accomplished. Our prayer we make through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, and to raise to you a hymn of glory and praise, O Lord God, Father of infinite goodness. For by the word of your Son's gospel, you have brought together one church from every people, tongue, and nation. And having filled her with life through the power of the Holy Spirit, you never cease through her to gather the whole human race into one. Manifesting the covenant of your love, she dispenses without ceasing the blessed hope of your kingdom, and shines bright as a sign of your faithfulness,
which in Christ Jesus our Lord you promised would last for all eternity. And so, with all the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and together with all the church, with one voice, we acclaim, Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on our journey of life. Blessed also your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask you to send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Saviour, whom you led through passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your own right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. We offer you the bread of life, the chalice of blessing. Look with favour on this offering of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ handed on to us. Grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of the body of your Son, in whom we have communion. Lord, renew your church by the light of the gospel. Strengthen the bonds of unity between the faithful and the pastors of your people, together with Francis our Pope, John our Bishop, the whole order of bishops, that in the world torn by strife, your people may shine forth as a prophetic sign of unity and concord. Remember our brothers and sisters fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, the apostles and martyrs, St. Conval and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Christ Jesus, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever. Amen. Amen. For the coming of God's kingdom, we pray in the words the Lord Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my own peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the Spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished with this bread, this heavenly bread, one in mind and in heart. Our prayer we make through Christ our Lord. Amen. Can I ask you to familiarise yourself with the latest notices in all the usual ways? With the end of the Christmas season, that we did a wee stock take, and with £300 of your donations plus all the treats, toiletries and tins that you gave us, we were able to make up 60 food parcels as well as 150 Christmas dinners and 40 Christmas goodie bags and distribute them. We're just going to continue that because it's really appreciated by people in need. So we'll continue to collect donations of tins, treats and toiletries, and we'll continue to make up bags as well. There are always half a dozen in the porch here, so if you know anybody who needs one, please take one for them. And if they get taken, we'll just replace them. And we'll continue to do that as best we can. I think it's a very significant witness and a very important good work for us to do as a parish community. So thank you for supporting it so generously. Thanks for being here this evening. Hope you have a nice evening despite the weather, and a good day tomorrow and a nice week. If anyone's worried about getting home safe and sound, please tell me and we'll get somebody to give you a lift. Let's ask God's blessing. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God.